5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Welcome aboard the world's longest flight!
Okay, 23 minutes down. I put my stopwatch on my iPhone so I can keep track of how long it's gone. 23 minutes gone. We still have then 16 and a half hours to go. I'm going to put a little timer at the top of the screen actually so you can see how long we've been flying for. One potentially minor hiccup is that my seat appears to be broken. The reclining function doesn't recline. I think you can still turn it into a bed because it just pulled the back down. I'll show you how the bed works a little later on, but the reclining functions aren't actually working. Look, if you press the button, it just kind of moves a little bit, then stops. So that could be interesting. So if the seat doesn't move, I might be sitting upright for 16 and a half hours. Why is this the world's longest flight? Well, we're going to embark in this plane non-stop to fly. It's 15,344 kilometers between Singapore and Newark. Now, to put that into a bit of perspective, the second longest flight in the world is the Qatar-operated flight between Auckland and Doha, and that's 14,535 kilometers long. So this flight is over 800 kilometers longer than the second longest flight in the world. Not even the flight that Qantas operate between Perth and London on the Dreamliner, the 787, is as long as this flight. That one is 14,499 kilometers. And so today we're almost going to be traveling 1,000 kilometers longer than the flight that Qantas operate between Australia and the UK. That's just bonkers when I think about it.
I can't take that.
Not sure how many food meals we're going to get on this flight actually. That's the dinner service. It's kind of 1 o'clock in the morning local time and we are about an hour and a half into the flight. Allow me to give you a tour of my seat. First of all, let's start here. You've got good laptop power options on the left hand side of you as you're sitting down. You've also got USB power. There's something saying iPod, I don't really know what that is. And there's an HDMI input as well, which I think will play whatever you're playing through to the TV screen in front of you. So if you've got movies on your laptop with an HDMI output, I haven't tested it, don't take my word for it, but potentially you could connect it to that and then watch your movies on the big screen in front of you. There's storage, good storage to the left-hand side. And what I do like is there's plenty of reading light options. So you've got one over to your left, three over to your right-hand side, and they've all got settings like two lighting power settings. So there's kind of like a low level at a high level. All the buttons for your lights and your reclining and everything is down the right hand side, plus that's where the do not disturb button is as well if you are asleep and you don't want to be woken up for the meal service. Over to your left then, this is where you have this little control unit. This is where you operate the TV. It's a table on the left, another storage unit. This is where your noise cancelling headphones go. And then another pocket down here, which is where you've got your menu, you've got your safety card, magazine. Now, quick seat update. My seat is broken. Yeah, they did the classic IT thing. They turned it off and on again. Actually, they did that twice. The buttons moved the chair a little bit before that. After they did the reset, the buttons do nothing. So I can turn that light up there on and off, but that's it. I'm stuck in the upright position for the whole of the flight. I can turn this into a bed though, and I'll show you that in a second because this folds down into a bed. Not using electrics, you just fold the back. I'll show you in a minute. Then I'm gonna use that bed and I'm gonna sleep very well. I'm hoping to get at least 5 or 6 hours sleep. When I wake up, should be light outside, and hopefully have a bit of a wander around the cabin as well. But for now.
Good morning.
That was like a 9 hours sleep, I think. That was a monster sleep for a flight.
One thing I really like about this bed is there's a little kind of foothold at the end, so if you are quite tall like me, you kind of, instead of lying straight, you lie on an angle, put your feet in the foothold. I'm sure it's not called that. The other good thing is the seatbelt that goes across you when you're lying down fully flat is one of those retractable seatbelts, so it's not fixed. So if you're rolling around, it kind of expands and contracts with you. I do have a problem sometimes on flatbeds when the seatbelt is fixed and you kind of want to roll around and you feel like you have to loosen it and then roll around. And they've woken us up for a breakfast service, I think it's going to be. If you don't want that, my tip is make sure you click on the do not disturb sign before you go to bed if you want to continue sleeping through. Otherwise, what they did with me is they will wake you up and ask you if you want the food service. I said no to start with, but then about 5 minutes later I thought. If your seat isn't fully latched back, so if it's not clicked into the position back, then the buttons won't work. So here's a tip to travellers and to Singapore Airlines, who didn't seem to be able to figure that out as well, but make sure your seat back is back and locked, so it's clicked in if you're trying to recline your seat. So if you're pressing the buttons and it doesn't work, push it back, click, you should be good.
It's very important when you're on such a long flight to make sure you stay hydrated as well. Like 16, 17 hours on a plane. I wish there was a better solution than plastic bottles though. Maybe like a Singapore Airlines branded like mini water bottle that you can use afterwards as well when you're off the plane. And drinking water from a tap so you can just go up and refill it yourself. Then at least you've got the bottle, you're not using plastic, and when you get off the plane you're kind of spreading the word about the branding because you're drinking out of a Singapore Airlines bottle as well. I don't know, just a thought.
So Brian, would you like to have the chicken and lamb satay or you prefer the nuts?
Oh, just the nuts, thank you. Yes, thank you.
Wow, I don't think I've ever done this before. We're flying over Alaska. We're just about to cross the coast of Alaska now. And then we're tracking almost overhead Anchorage in about another 10 minutes. That view out there, look at this. I've honestly not seen anything like that. Selfless person and I want to do everything I can for you on this channel, I wasn't going to have dessert, but I decided to ask for it just so I could sample it for you. I will now rank my desserts in priority from fourth, not worst, but like the least best to the best, because they're all really good. But my ordering is as follows. I don't count the fruit because, well, a fruit doesn't count. So the other cool thing about this flight to remember is, so we took off, you'll remember, at night time. It was about midnight in Singapore when we took off. Flew through the night, sun came up, and now we're traveling through the daytime. But because we're flying in an easterly direction, and obviously the shadow moves in a westerly direction across the globe, that means that we've got a really short day on this flight. And what's actually about to happen is we've got a sunset happening outside. The sun's going to go down and we're going to get our second night on board this plane. I've never flown on a plane where I've had two nights without touching the wheels down on the ground in between. It's kind of cool, right? Thank you. lying down or sitting down for, you know, hours and hours and hours at a time, it's important to stretch your legs. I sound like a dad. It's very important. Stretch your legs. Drink lots of water. No, drink lots of water. That's really important too.
Serving you on this flight. Thank you for flying Singapore Airlines, a member of Star Alliance.